Good readers can read large words correctly, or we can call those multisyllabic words. We see those in books all the time, so we have to know how to read those correctly. I'm going to put a word on our board, and when I show it to you, be thinking, are there any prefixes or suffixes without shouting out, thumbs up, thumbs down, or like I'm not for sure. Okay, what do you see?
Ing.
All right, let's cover up ing. I know we can read this base word. What's the word?
Tap.
Okay, now let's add the ing, blend.
Tapping,
word.
Tapping.
Good job, that makes sense. So we probably read it correctly. All right, prefix or suffix, thumbs up, thumbs down. What do you see?
S.
S, anything else? That ER could be one, but we're not quite for sure. So let's find the vowels. Vowel?
A.
Could be A. I like that you said A. We'll see what works. And? But that G will say? Good job.
Ranger. Ranger.
Good. Let's add the S.
Ranger.
Word.
Ranger.
Good job. That makes sense. Prefix or suffix? What do you see?
Ing.
All right. There used to be an E there. Vowel sound? Blend.
Rumble. Rumble.
Good job. That's the base word. Add the ing.
Rumbling.
Word?
Rumbling.
We don't need to say rumbling. We can just say rumbling. Either way is fine. Rumbling. Okay? Rumbling. Prefix, suffix? Some of you are like, oh, I'm not for sure. What are you not for sure on? The er. Possibly, but you know it says er, so let's just leave it at that. Okay, vowel sound? Blend?
Woodpecker. Woodpecker.
Okay, it made sense. Good job. If it didn't, we could switch some of those vowel sounds around. Last one. Prefix, suffix? Ooh, some of you are like maybe, some of you are like yeah, what?
Dis.
Maybe dis. So let's cover it up. Vowel sound? Blend?
Dis.
Can't. Let's add the dis.
Distance. Distance.
Your brains change the a to an is sound. Distant. We wouldn't say distant. The word is distant. That's what makes sense. And that's also a vocabulary word this week, so good job. As we read this story, our goal is to read every word correct, especially those large words we just worked on. If you're stuck on a word, use a strategy we just practiced. If you're still stuck, raise your hand, and I will be glad to help. All right, we're going to read this page in a quiet voice so you don't disturb your neighbor. I'll say stop, and then we'll reread together. Okay, whisper, whisper, whisper. Let me zoom up. And stop. I am the first word. What's the word?
Tap.
Okay, ready, begin.
Tap, tap, tap. Could this be it? Is this the rain at last? No, it's a Gila woodpecker tapping on a tall green cactus.
I love that you remembered that this animal is a Gila woodpecker. We've read about the Gila woodpecker before. Good job. Not Gila or Jila. It's a Spanish name. Excellent written remembering. Whisper, whisper, whisper. Thank you.
first word. What's the word?
The.
Best reading. Ready, begin.
The toad feels the ground begin to shake. Then a crunch, crunch, crunch. That's loud. Is this the rain? No, it's a park ranger's boots walking on the path.
Excellent job reading words correct. Your voice even sounds pretty nice. Whisper, whisper, whisper. Stop. Eye on the first word. What's the word?
What?
Present. Great question. You will get to see the pictures during comprehension. We're going to use this during comprehension. Okay? Right now it's like a sneak peek. Okay? Here we go.
What about that tiss, tiss, tiss? Is this the rain at last? No, it's the rattle of the rattlesnake giving warning. Stay away!
I love how you raised your volume on stay away. When an author writes words in maybe all capitals, that would be a great spot to do that. Good job. Last page for this lesson. Read those large words correct. Whisper, whisper, whisper. Stop. Eye on the first word. What's the word?
Surely.
Good. It's our sight word with Lee. Surely. Okay, ready? Begin.
Surely that rumbling, that rumble, rumbling, surely that's the rain. Not yet. It's the thunder of a distant storm, but perhaps the rain is near.
Okay, good job reading large words correctly. When good readers read large words correctly, it will really help us understand what we read. Because otherwise, we just made up our own words and we didn't read what the author wrote.